EuroFX started the day basically consolidating around the flat line. Euro stocks hit a 13-year high. That definitely helped. Also, seeing treasury yields in the Eurozone up on the day, that was offset by pretty bad economic data. Eurozone trade balance number came out much smaller than expected, 6.1 billion versus 11.5 billion consensus. Also heard from Lagarde, from the ECB, talking about the inflation spike once again being temporary and a hike in 2022 is still very unlikely. From that point, we got into the meat of the session here in the U.S., and the euro currency began to falter ever so slightly. COVID cases in the Eurozone on the rise, that hit the press, specifically Dutch Prime Minister and in Germany, that they might have to reinstate measures against COVID. Also saw yields here in the U.S. rise, so that did help. Also had a pretty good number with the Empire Manufacturing Report, helped boosting the dollar and also yields. But other than that, we had traders seem to be waiting for this virtual summit between President Xi of China and President Biden of the U.S., regards to perhaps bringing together the tensions that we have right now. Also waiting for Tuesday's retail sales and a lot of housing numbers on Wednesday. Also a lot of Fed speak both tomorrow and Wednesday. Now looking at options volatility, I look at the CME Group CVOL, December volatility, 1 month basis trading about the 85th percentile, 3 month basis actually at the 95th percentile. Today, at the money vols are slightly lower. Both up variance and down variance, or call wing and put wing, are both lower, but equally so. So skew is unchanged. Looking at trading volume and options, seeing a lot of the volume clustered along tenors around the 25 delta call area on the put side, the 30 to 35 delta put.